to be here with all of you and to meet with God and experience His goodness. Let's just pray. Our Father in heaven, we welcome you into this place tonight. Lord, our desire is to gaze upon your beauty. Lord, we want to get to know you even more intimately. And we want to experience more of the depths of your presence. Lord, we know that your greatness and your goodness and your kindness and your love, it is entirely beyond our ability to fathom and our ability to comprehend. And so, Lord, we just open ourselves up to you tonight. We ask that you would just have your way with us, Lord, and that above everything, you would be enthroned here tonight. So come and reign in your temple. Come and have your way. Come and receive from us our worship and our affection and our lives surrendered to you once again. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. And everyone who agreed said, amen.
We worship you, Jesus. Lift up your song to Him. We just want to bless your name, Lord. Oh, there's none like you, Jesus. There's a sound.
There is a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as He walks into the room where people pray, where we hear praises, He hears. There is a sound I love to hear. It's the sound of the Savior's robe as He walks into the room where people pray, where we hear worship, He hears in faith.
Wake my soul.
Wake my soul and sing. Sing His praise aloud. Sing His praise aloud. Wake my soul and sing. Sing His praise aloud. Sing His praise aloud.
When He moves, and when we pray. I stood a wall, now stands away, but every promise is amen. And when he moves, make no mistake, the bowels of hell begin to shake. Oh, hail the Lord, oh, hail the King. And when he moves, and when we pray, I stood a wall, now stands away, where every promise is amen.
they would pour your spirit out. Said they would form the sons and daughters. So come. Come and blow on you.
Yes.
Lord, we want to see you. We want to know you. Just thank you that you are here. Just declare the Lord is here. You're not far, you're close, you're near. Jesus, you are Lord and King and worthy of our praise. And we thank you how you've revealed yourself. And we just ask tonight, we want to see more of you. We want to encounter you more. We want to see your beauty. We want to see your glory. We want your truth and the reality of your love to touch us and transform us and fill us afresh. We just say we need that. That's the one thing that we need, is to see you, is to encounter you, is to know your presence, is to be filled with your spirit. So we just ask for that, Lord, for us tonight. Just ask for your presence and power and peace, Lord. So we're just going to stay in a place of worship and just focusing our attention on him. And we're going to do that through using scripture to worship with the word. So I just encourage you to continue to engage just with what God's doing. But if you'd like, you can grab a Bible and we're going to go through some verses in Luke 22. These are the verses of Jesus sharing the Last Supper just before he went to the cross. Kind of the way it works is we're going to sing through and read through these passages and these guys will make up some songs and choruses, and just encourage you to meditate on the verses and to sing and just be open to the Spirit speaking through the word, and just encourage you to pray into that and to worship into that as well. And then we'll just sort of see where it goes. So we just ask that you'd speak, Lord, through this time. We're just going to start with this first section in Luke 22 from verses 14 to 19. Says, when the hour came, Jesus and his apostles reclined at the table, and he said to them, taking the cup, he gave thanks and said, gave thanks and broke it and gave it to them, saying,
this is my body given to you, so do this in remembrance of me.
This is my body given for you, do this in remembrance of me.
Thank you for
In the same way, after the supper, he took the cup, saying,
"This cup is the new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you. Oh, it's poured out for you. The hand of him who is going to betray."
The new covenant in my blood, which is poured out for you.
No.
Jesus, you poured out your blood for us. Before we go into the last section, if you're here, you would have been given a little packet with communion as you entered. If you're at home, you might like to grab something for communion. And yeah, we're just going to celebrate what Jesus has told us to do as we remember. Just encourage you just in the next couple of moments to take the bread and take the juice. Just realize, like he said to his disciples, let him speak to you, that he gives this, he's giving it, he gives his body to you, he gives and pours out his blood for you, he chose to do it. Just encourage you, just take that over the next couple of moments. just going to go to the last section. We're actually going to do it from Mark chapter 10. It's the same story of a situation that happens after this supper when the disciples are arguing about who is going to be the greatest, and Jesus redefines greatness. So it's going to sing from Mark 10, 43 to 45.
And not so with you. Instead, who forever wants to become great among you must be a servant. And whoever wants to be first must be a slave of
even the Son of Man did not come to be served.
He came to serve. He did not come to be served.
Even the Son of Man did not come to be served.
Savior is a servant.
The King of Kings, a servant.
The King, a servant.
My Savior is a servant. The King of Kings, a servant. Oh,
my Savior is a servant.
Just say the greatest. Is a servant.
The King of Kings is servant.
You are the Lord and you are a servant.
My Savior is a servant.
And you went to a cross as a servant.
The King of Kings is servant.
You gave your life as a ransom for us. We worship you, Jesus. You're worthy.
You are.
Yes, you are worthy.
Gentle and kind, with a heart of compassion, your goodness overflows, your goodness overflows. This I know, this I know. Goodness overflows. Goodness overflows. This I know. This I know. Goodness overflows. Goodness overflows. This I know. This I know.
Yeah. Oh, let me be the leader. Yeah, I get off the throne that's in my heart, and I give you my heart. This is my desire. Give you my heart.
put it all on the altar. We lay it all down. We give it all to you, Jesus. Let your fire fall on our sacrifice. Let your fire fall. This is for your glory. All of this is for your glory. All of this is for your glory. All of this is for your glory. So we give you our love. Is yours.
our dreams, all of our hopes, all of our aspirations. Lord, we fully surrender it all to you. But how could we hold it back? But after you've given everything for us, you've given your body, you've given your blood, you came as a servant to serve. But after all of this, how could we hold back? Lord, your beauty is so compelling. Your glory is so captivating. Lord, as you've given yourself completely to us, Lord, we completely give ourselves back to you. God, we thank you so much that we get to know you. Lord, that we get to live our lives with your presence. That our future with you is guaranteed as our bridegroom. That nothing will ever be able to separate us from your love. Lord, we know that you've heard our cries here tonight. Lord, all that we are is surrendered to you, and we ask that your fire would fall upon us, God. We ask that you would purge us of everything that is not pleasing in your sight. Pray that you would ignite within us a passion for your name. We pray that a devotion would rise up from within us, that unlike anything we've experienced in our lives before. By your Spirit, would you do these things, Lord? Stir it up, God. Don't hold back. Glory of your great name, and in the wonderful name of Jesus. Everyone who agreed said, amen. Awesome. So am I supposed to do like the finality stuff now? So there's tea, right?
No one's ever sure. It's the same every week. Go on. Tea and fellowship. Enjoy.